This is the Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. The Wallow Fire in Arizona has become the largest in the state's history. It's burned almost a half million acres, forced nearly 10,000 people to evacuate their homes, and more than 4,300 firefighters are trying to get it under control. Today, we'll take a closer look at a small group of firefighters known as Apache 8. It was until recently staffed almost exclusively by women from the White Mountain Apache tribe. The crew has been around for more than 30 years. We'll talk to the producer and director of the documentary on the crew in just a moment. Here's a clip from Apache 8.
You never knew what you were going to face. You were with a bunch of women that could handle anything.
This whole concept of having women was rather taboo to this local area. The society here heavily depends on the men folk and having the jobs.
I work with the helitack, and that's part of the air operations department. We did have a helicopter go down, and we had two fatalities, the pilot and one of our crew members.
The wildfires in the West, at least 30 major wildfires are burning, including a 6,000-acre fire in Arizona's Fort Apache Reservation.
There's no way you can stop that fire because it was really running like crazy.
The wind was so strong, I don't know how many miles per hour it was. It just went down and our vehicles shook.
We ran into a couple of crews from Montana, and they go, man, we hear a lot of stuff about how just nothing but ladies can outwork some of these men. And we're like, yeah, pretty much can.
We bypassed everybody on that crew, up that mountain, down, back up. And then when we got there, everybody was asking, who are you? Who are you? And we're like, White Mountain Apache, Apache 8. Thank you very much.
Joining us now is the film's director and producer, Sande Zeig. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you, Hari. Thank you.
All right, in terms of the Wallow Fire, where are they now? Where are the Apache 8 members? What's their involvement?
Right now they're in a spike camp, which is a camp that they set up called the Maverick Camp. It's also a city. And they've been there almost 10 days now. And there are six Apache 8 crew members there.
And how's their health? How have they been faring?
I just asked this morning how everyone was doing. And actually, Irene Hinton, one of our firefighters, was just sent off. I think that there was just an excess of smoke inhalation. So she was just sent home yesterday.
So the crew is now co-ed at the end of your documentary. You mentioned that, but it had been all women for an incredibly long time.
That's right. Apache 8 was probably the first and longest lasting all-women crew in the United States and composed of entirely Apache crews. From the very beginning, which was over a 30-year period, from the very first women crew, there were over 100 women who were firefighters on Fort Apache. And they went out all across the country. They would do quite a lot of work on the reservation in terms of fire prevention, but they went out to many, many states across the country to fight fire.
What has become of these women now? There are a couple of the women that you're able to give updates to in the documentary, but you've kept up with them over the years. Have they all continued to stay in the service? Are some of them retired?
Katie Aday, who was one of our firefighters, she had become a commander in the Navy. She left firefighting, and so she was the only one in the film that we featured who is no longer actively firefighting. Cheryl Bones was the original Apache 8 crew boss, and she is at retirement age, but she has not retired. She's still working. I just spoke to her this morning. She's still at fire management. She gave me an update on what was happening in the Wallow Fire and how they were doing backburns to actually save the reservation.
I've got to ask, you talked to so many of these women. Is there a common thread? What is it about them that makes them strong enough, hardy enough to go into these woods and do an incredibly physically demanding job?
These women are incredibly inspirational, and they have a fortitude. They will really accept any challenge, and they excel. They go out there and they excel, and I found this across the board with everyone, you know, a passion for their work, you know, for the service that they're doing both on the reservation for the Apache people and for everyone in the nation. They have an extraordinary fortitude. It's just, they are strong women.
All right. Sande Zeig is the producer and director of Apache 8, a documentary on what used to be an all-female wildland firefighting unit for members of the White Mountain Apache tribe. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you so much.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. Stay with us.